you would think that interest would fade. But interest has not faded.
Paul Darrow. The agent liked it. So that's who I've been for more than 50 years. Growing up in what I now realise was a turbulent decade, I reckon the future offered me but two alternatives. World domination or show business. For better or for worse, I chose the latter. A thought struck me. If I got bored with one occupation, I could take on another. All in the land of make-believe. I could become an actor.
Well, Britain it has been since Julius's time.
Conditions have made you redundant. It's not quite the same thing.
What's the difference?
That check I've just given you for a year's salary and the kind of reference you'll get. That's the difference.
Well, that is your decision, ma'am.
Can't talk to you through a door, Sasha. And we need to talk, me and you. Mickey, everything.
Oh, no, signor. Your key. A sweet eight. And when I got your letter, I wanted to run out of my chambers and dance all round the Temple Gardens. However, it's bad form for barristers to use the gardens, so I reluctantly concluded that even a smallish dance would draw attention, and not the sort I need.
Are you daring to accuse me of having anything to do with this?
Nobody's accusing anybody of anything.
Well, yes, sir, but there is something else.
Yes?
Well, a moment ago, I thought I heard a funny kind of a noise, sir.
Well, what kind of noise?
The world is round.
Captain! The edge of the world!
Rather like that sound we heard in the cave, sir.
A safe, madame?
For my jewels.
Oh, yes, yes. We have a special vault for all our guests.
We don't have any soup tonight.
Thing is, my friend here, his mouth is wired shut, his teeth have been reduced to the consistency of powder, he's in considerable oral pain, and the only thing he can eat is soup.
Well, they certainly made a meal out of that one.
Sir, in Hull, there is very little Wellington moth can't find out. What are you after?
What?
What are you trying to prove?
What? I'm not trying to prove.
Asking all these questions.
I'm looking for a mate of mine. Named Tank.
You're a wily fox, Nottingham. What are you driving at?
It is not for me to advise a prince. I've just been sent for to a case. Would you come with me, sir?
We will proceed no further with this business. He hath honoured me of late, and I have bought golden opinions from all sorts of people.
It is a case of murder.
Thank you, good captain, but not by your hand. By the axe, if you will.
I think that the motive was robbery, and that the killing was probably accidental, but that still makes it murder.
Ah, yes. Well, you shouldn't believe everything that people tell you, Doctor.
Of course, my dear. But Giles appealed and won. You appealed to the Lords against that, and they turned you down. Stumps are drawn. What?
When he gambled and lost and had nothing left to give, he paid with his blood.
I'm a good shot with any kind of a missile. I realized how easily a man could be plugged through the skylight.
So you've got to ask yourself the question. Do I feel lucky?
None of us are blind here. We can all see the equipment. We know that it's meter tampering you're talking about. Just get to the point.
So you know. Well, my offer still stands. In fact, I may be able to persuade my client to go above 250.
I watched the executions from that window. I like to when I can.
Permit me, sir. Painful as my position is in seeming to entertain an opinion different to yours, I must ask, Mr. Dombey, had you not better consider the question of a separation?
You mistake your position in offering me advice on such a point.
Perhaps you mistake my position.
Not at all, sir. You were employed...
Ah, for the humiliation of Mrs. Dombey. Yes, I had forgot. I do beg your pardon.
Remember me, please.
You're going to have to excuse this. Thank you for your interest. I was alive when Elvis burst on the scene. And I remember it as if it were yesterday. It's now or never. Wonderful. He used to get these terrific notes. And that's why I adored the man. And it was the play called Are You Lonesome Tonight by Alan Bleasdale. And for 6 months I played Elvis.
You look like an angel. Walk like an angel. Talk like an angel. But I got wise. You're the devil in disguise. Oh, yes, you are. Devil in disguise. You fool me with your kisses. You cheated and you schemed. Heaven knows how you lied to me. You're not the way you seem. You look like an angel. Walk like an angel. Talk like an angel. But I got wise. You're the devil in disguise. Oh, yes, you are. Devil in disguise. That I was in heaven, but I was sure surprised. Heaven help me, I didn't see the devil in your eyes. You look like an angel, walk like an angel, talk like an angel, but I got wise. Sky. Oh, yes, you are. Devil in the sky. You're the devil in the sky. Oh, yes, you are. Devil in the sky. Yes, you are. Devil in the sky. Oh, yes, you are.
Devil in the sky. Hello. You're about to see an episode of Blake 7.
The Liberator was on a rescue mission.
Yeah. Another one. We did things like that in the early days when Blake was at the helm. But don't worry. I'll soon change all that. Lord Avon. I quite like the sound of that. Of course, Avon has got a little something up his sleeve. Didn't I always?
My name is Avon.
Kerr Avon. When it comes to computers, he's the number two man in all the Federated worlds.
Who's number one?
The guy who caught him.
We had one chance. You wasted it. There won't be a next time.
In which case, you can die content.
Content?
Knowing that you were right.
Don't you ever get bored with being right?
Just with the rest of you being wrong.
Avon's right.
I usually am.
And if you're wrong?
If I'm wrong, you can say I told you so, provided you speak loudly and quickly.
And you were right. That must be a novel experience for you.
He who trusts can never be betrayed, only mistaken. Callie once told me that that was a saying amongst her people.
Callie?
A man who trusts can never be betrayed, only mistaken.
Callie was murdered. So were most of her people.
Life expectancy must be fairly short among your people.
Auron may be different, Callie, but on Earth it is considered ill-mannered to kill your friends while committing suicide. I presume you have no tedious scruples about cheating and lying.
None at all.
Oh, good. Idealism is a wonderful thing. All you really need is someone rational to put it to proper use.
I think we make a good team.
Well, hooray for us.
That's the trouble with heroics. They seldom run to schedule.
Avon, this is stupid!
When did that ever stop us?
Well, what are you waiting for?
I was aiming for his head.
What did you want me to do? Give him a sporting chance? Don't philosophize at me, you electronic moron. Answer the question.
Zen!
Stick to the distress beacon, Aurak. When I want your impersonation of a pain, I will let you know.
You know Aurak's main drawback.
He's too useful to destroy.
Irritating, isn't it?
Oh, that's very good. You may turn out to be my kind of computer after all.
Sentiment breeds weakness. Let it get a hold of you and you are dead.
Regret is part of being alive. But keep it a small part.
As you do?
Demonstrably. I have never understood why it should be necessary to become irrational in order to prove that you care. Or indeed, why it should be necessary to prove it at all.
Of all the things I have known myself to be, I never recognized the fool.
Your skin always did come first, didn't it?
Would you reproach me for that?
You'd sell out anybody, wouldn't you?
I don't know. I never really had an offer I felt was worthy of me.
Have you murdered your way to the wall of an underground room?
It's an old wall, Avon. It waits.
Imagination my only limit. I'd be dead in a week.
He doesn't know you as well as I do.
Who does?
Anybody comes through this door, kill them. Anybody that isn't me, that is. You know what they say. No good deed goes unpunished.
What would you know about guilt?
Only what I've read.
No, I'm not. I am not expendable. I'm not stupid. And I'm not going.
If you didn't want the answer, you shouldn't have asked the question.
What are you doing on my ship?
Your ship? This is my ship.
And frankly, I can't even guess at a motive.
Try greed. It's usually reliable. Wealth is the only reality. They have a sentimental value for me.
Oh, family heirlooms, huh?
No, I'm just sentimental about money.
Avon, there are times when I almost get to like you.
Yes, well, that makes it all worthwhile.
I got this shocking pain right behind the eyes.
Have you considered amputation?
I don't follow you.
Oh, but you do. And that's the problem.
I'm entitled to my opinion.
It is your assumption that we are entitled to it as well that is irritating.
It's a trip I won't forget, Avon.
Well, as you always say, villain, you know you are safe with me. Don't try and manipulate me, Blake.
Death is something that he and I faced together on a number of occasions. I always thought that his death and mine might be linked in some way.
Blake would have been proud of you, you know.
I know, but then he never was very bright. Staying with you requires a degree of stupidity of which I no longer feel capable.
Now you're just being modest.
And I want it finished. I want it over and done with. I want to be free.
But you are free now, Avon.
I want to be free of him. Couldn't you bring yourself to trust me just this once? Have you betrayed us? Have you betrayed me?
For what it is worth, I have always trusted you from the very beginning.
The rumors of my death
have been greatly exaggerated.
Well, slightly exaggerated anyway.
Much. Are happy. You happy with that one?
Ecstatic.
Right, number two.
You loved it, didn't you? I can tell. In the end, all I want, what all actors want, is to be remembered for something. Having played a key role in B7, I am a part of it whether I like it or not. I like it. I do not complain. I don't mind being Forever Avon.